वालिकर वर्क्स इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर ए लेक्चर ऑन इंट्रोडक्शन टू वायरलेस सेंसर नेटवर्क्स एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशंस. एज पार्ट ऑफ अ लर्निंग आउटकम एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डिस्क्राइब द वायरलेस सेंसर नेटवर्क्स एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशंस. सो बिफोर डिस्कसिंग आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ वायरलेस सेंसर नेटवर्क्स and its components and applications, let we'll begin with a definition of wireless sensor networks. The wireless sensor networks are the self-configured infrastructureless networks in which the sensor nodes are remotely senses a physical conditions such as temperature, pressure, wind and other moleculars across a remote sensing areas and pass that information to the central control authority for extracting a knowledge. Usually wireless sensor networks are consist of a wireless sensor nodes and usually called as smart devices. These wireless sensor nodes are typically low cost, low power, small devices equipped with limited sensing, data processing and wireless communication capabilities as well as a power supply capability. They leverage the concept of wireless networks in which a large number of collaborative sensor nodes could be deployed across a hostile area. As an outcome of the convergence of microelectronic mechanical system, that is MEMS technology, wireless communications and digital electronics, wireless sensor networks represent a significant improvement over a traditional sensors. In fact, the rapid evolution of wireless sensor network technology has accelerated the development and deployment of various novel types of wireless sensors such as multimedia sensors, multi-op sensors, single-op sensors and static sensors, dynamic sensors, ad hoc sensors, etc. To fulfilling Moore's law, wireless sensors are becoming smaller and cheaper, and at the same time, the more powerful and ubiquitous sensor nodes are available in the market for the users. The design complexity of wireless sensor node depends on the specific application requirements, such as the number of nodes, the power consumptions, the life span of the sensors. Now we will discuss about classification of wireless sensor networks. The wireless sensor networks are classified based on the nature of the nodes and based on the configurations, based on the deployment and based on the type of sensors and based on the architecture and based on the sensing capacity. And based on this, and these are the type of sensors, one is static and mobile wireless sensor networks in which the nodes are available either as a static or either in mobile. In static wireless network, the nodes are static, they have only sensing capabilities. In mobile wireless sensor network, along with sensing capability, the sensors also having a movable capable or moving capabilities in which the sensors will move from one location to the another location in order to sense physical conditions within a sensing field or sensing area. In deterministic and non-deterministic wireless sensor network, it classified based on the how the sensor nodes are placed. In deterministic wireless sensor networks, nodes are systematically placed in keeping quality in mind. In non-deterministic wireless sensor network, the nodes are randomly distributed without keeping quality in mind. Single base station and multi base station wireless sensor network. In single base station, only one coordinator is there that will act as a base station that will send a signals to other sensors and also receives information from other sensors. And multi base stations, a number of multiple coordinators or you may say base stations are there and each are having connecting a group of sensors. Static base station and mobile base station, again these bases or base stations are static in nature and mobile in nature. single hop and multi hop wireless sensor network. In single hop wireless sensor network, the only one single hop is that intermediate is there between sending and receiver sensors. In multi hop sensor network, multiple intermediate nodes or multiple intermediate sensors are placed between sensor sender and receivers. Self reconfigurable and non self reconfigurable wireless sensor network, in which the nodes are having the self reconfigurable inheritance and non self configurable features. Homogeneous and heterogeneous wireless sensor network. In homogeneous network, sensors, all sensors are having similar configurations with respect to software and hardware, but in heterogeneous wireless sensor network, the different sensors having a different hardware and software configurations. Again, static and mobile, as already told, the static means the nodes are static in nature. In mobile, the nodes are moving from one location to the another location. And mobile wireless sensor network, sometimes also called ad hoc wireless sensor networks. As explained theoretically, so this is a pictorial representation of a type of sensors. So as I already told, sensors, wireless sensor networks are classified based on the sensors. So static wireless sensor network, mobile wireless sensor network, hybrid wireless sensor network, robot wireless sensor network, and based on the deployment strategies, either they may be exist deterministic or a random placement of the wireless sensor nodes, and based on the architecture, the wireless sensor network might be flat in nature or clustered in nature, and so nodes may be move from one place to the another place with having some intent. So that is called intentional movement of the sensor node, and unintentional, without having any intention, if the nodes are moving from one location to the another location, so such a wireless sensor network are called unintentional wireless sensor network. Based on the coverage area also, they are classified with respect to what type of coverage area they are moving, and also at what degree level they are moving, and they will define in terms of model, function, results, so based on the sensing capacity of the sensors used in the wireless sensor networks. So this is an architecture of wireless sensor network, and so this is a sensing field or sensing area, and these are called what? A spatial distributed sensors, and these sensors cooperatively working together, and they have a multi hop or a single hop structure, and all these sensors will senses environmental or physical conditions such as temperature, wind, speed, chemical particles and other informations, and send to the central system or computerized system where user is accessing those information via internet. So once the information being sensed by the sensors and sent to the users, and user will apply the processing, analyzing and extracting knowledge from the those sensed informations. And this is how the sensor will sense the information from a different locations, then it will pass that information to the users. So this, in this way, the sensor architecture is built. And while building this wireless sensor network, the sensor technology play in a vital role. The wireless sensor nodes in the wireless sensor network might be considered as a computing resources, might be exist as a sensor interfaces or software architectures, protocol stack, etc. These nodes can be used in various real-time applications to perform various tasks like smart detecting, discovery of neighbor nodes within a particular sensing area. Also used in data processing, data collection, target tracking, monitor and controlling, synchronization, node localization, and effective routing between the base station and nodes in a wireless sensor network. So these are the components of wireless sensor nodes. The usually wireless sensor nodes consisting of four units. First one is sensing unit, processing unit, communication units, and last one is power unit. Sensing unit consisting of real sensors. Those sensor will sense physical conditions, then send it to the analog to digital converter. So this ADC will convert this physical energy into analog signals. That analog signals will send to the processing unit. In processing unit, those analog signals are processed with the help of microprocessor or microcontroller, and after processing, they will store in the memory. Then after that, that data is available for the user, and that information will send to the user via communication units. So all these units will get the power from a power unit, or you say it is a battery, in order to become an active in sensing or in performing the actions. All should have a minimum power, so that will be supplied by power unit to the sensors, microprocessors and communication links. So now we'll discuss different applications of wireless sensor networks. So wireless sensor networks might be used in air traffic control, heating, ventilation and air conditioning, industrial assembly line, automotive sensors, battlefield management and surveillance, biomedical applications, bridge and highway monitoring and disaster management. In all these, the network are deployed wirelessly, and all nodes are gather the information wirelessly, and collectively they will send the information to the central system, so that central system can take action or preventive measures to avoid any disaster. Think and write. So what are the components of sensor node? Pause the video now and answer the questions. These are the components of sensor node. Sensing unit that will sense the information across the remote area or across the sensing area. The power unit will supply power to all these remaining three units. The processing unit usually consists of microcontroller and microprocessor that enables the processing, analyzing of data as well as storing of the data. And communication unit consisting of radio links or communication links, so that will enables processing units or a node to send that information to the central system. And these are the references I referred to prepare the PPT, out of which the two are books and remaining are links where I collect the information and systematically I cited in the PPT. Thank you.